С вами снова я, Ольга Джерл и Amazing Russian. Здравствуйте! Today we are going to talk about the accusative case. Since it's a grammar tutorial for beginners, I'm explaining things in English. Many grammar textbooks tell you that if a verb is transitive, it takes the direct object. The direct object is used in the accusative case. Does it mean anything to you? I don't think so. The problem is that many people have no idea what the direct object is or what a transitive verb is. So let's go ahead and find out. What is a transitive verb? What is the direct object? What are accusative endings? I'm going to start with some English sentences. I am reading an interesting book. Masha loves her grandmother. My dog understands commands. They are watching a Russian movie. I know this word. I, Masha, my dog, they, I, they are subjects. Am reading, loves, understands, are watching, know, these are verbs or predicates. An interesting book, her grandmother, commands, a Russian movie, this word. These are direct objects. Why is it called the direct object? Because it comes directly after the verb. It answers the question what or whom. Am reading what? An interesting book. Loves whom? Her grandmother. And it receives the action of the verb. In our case, the verbs are transitive. Transitive verbs always require the usage of direct objects. Now I have the same sentences in Russian. Я читаю интересную книгу. Маша любит бабушку. Моя собака понимает команды. Они смотрят русский фильм. Я знаю это слово. Субъект. Я, Маша, моя собака, они, я. The subject in a Russian sentence is always in the nominative case. Именительный падеж. Читаю, любит, понимает, смотрят, знаю. Это предикат. Интересную книгу, бабушку, команды, русский фильм. Это слово. Это прямой объект. It answers the question «Что?», «Кого?», «Читаю что?», «Интересную книгу?», «Любит кого?», «Бабушку?». Прямой объект is always in the accusative case. Винительный падеж. Sometimes in a Russian sentence, the subject, the predicate, and the direct object are not arranged in a certain order. Они смотрят русский фильм. Читаю я интересную книгу. Бабушку любит Маша. Понимает команды моя собака. Это слово знаю я. If we arrange the words in a Russian sentence like this, the meaning will not change. But please note that only the first sentence is in a standard word order. Subject, predicate, object. Они смотрят русский фильм. The rest of the sentences have emphatic word order. The standard word order is recommended for beginners, so you have to focus on this one. But of course, you can see the emphatic word order in conversations. It's more common in conversations. Also, it's used for emotional emphasis, new information, or in poetry. Let's talk about accusative endings. First comes nouns. Please note that at this point we are dealing only with inanimate masculine and plural nouns, things, not people or other living things. So inanimate masculine and plural nouns as well as neuter nouns do not change in the accusative case. As you can see from the table, the only change in endings is in feminine nouns. They can be both animate or inanimate. Hard stem nouns ending in a will change into u, газета, газету. Soft stem ya will change into u, лекция, лекцию. Мягкий знак words like тетрадь, they do not change. Adjective endings. Again, only feminine adjectives change their endings. Hard stem «а-я» will be «у-ю», «новая» – «новую». Soft stem «я-я» will change into «ю-ю», «синяя» – «синюю». Possessives. Again, only feminine possessives change the endings in the accusative. Question word whose, чья, чью, моя, мою, твоя, твою, наша, нашу, ваша, вашу. Его, ее, их don't change. 8 transitive verbs you need to know. These verbs take direct objects, that's why they're called transitive. Читать, писать, знать, понимать, изучать, слушать, смотреть, любить. А теперь немного практики. Я понимаю. Моя мама will change into мою маму, because it's a feminine noun. Мы читаем. Интересная книга will change into интересную книгу. Студенты слушают. Лекция will change into лекцию. Я изучаю русский язык. It doesn't change. Masculine inanimate. Я люблю этот город. Мы читаем журнал. Мы смотрим интересное шоу. It doesn't change. It's a neuter noun with a modifier. Я читаю письмо. Я понимаю это слово. Папа читает документы. Документы doesn't change because it's plural inanimate. Я изучаю новые курсы. Мы знаем эти слова. Еще чуть-чуть практики. Я читаю хорошее письмо. The direct object хорошее письмо doesn't need a change? No, because it's neuter. Мы слушаем интересный курс. Change or no change? No, it's masculine inanimate. Он часто слушает русская музыка. Yes, it does need a change. It's a feminine noun. It will change into русскую музыку. Вы изучаете биологию. Change, no change? Yes, it needs a change. It's a feminine noun. Биология into биологию. Русские студенты часто читают американские книги. No change, it's plural. Она часто носит это синяя юбка. Yes, it needs a change. The feminine noun with modifiers. Эту синюю юбку. Мы любим наша страна Россия. Yes, it does need a change. Feminine. It will change into нашу страну Россию. Он не знает этот город. No change, masculine, inanimate. For more practice with the accusative case, go to the next video, Cases Training for Beginners. By the way, many more videos are coming this way. Please stay tuned.
На сегодня это все. Я с вами прощаюсь. До новых встреч!